Grotesque is a extreme, gory, violent, and even sometimes sexual Japanese torture horror film. People just looking for normal horror should look elsewhere, because this movie is just brutal, extreme torture scenes for basically the entire runtime of the entire movie. But if you are looking for something that is extreme and it essentially has that tension and those gross-out scenes, then this movie does not disappoint. I think it's very well done, and just considering that subgenre of films, this is one of the best. What I really like about this film is that it gets into the brutal, extreme, and even torture scenes right away. It doesn't waste any time. Some movies take 30 to 40 minutes before it gets into the core of the movie, but this movie knows that, you know, what it's all about is about torture, so it's not boring you with other scenes in the movie. It just gets, essentially, the main couple in the film, they get kidnapped almost instantly, and the scenes really begin. It doesn't take some time to get into it. Yet, on the other hand, I also like that this film does actually tell you about the characters a little bit more. It's not and just knowing nothing about the characters like maybe one or two of the guinea pig films. I mean, this film, you do get to learn about the characters, and what I really, really like about it is that you'll have these brutal, extreme scenes, and then you'll go to flashbacks of the characters, let's say where they first met and got to know each other, their first date, and then you go back to some of the torture. So it's almost done in a way where you get brutal scenes and then one scene to sort of mix it up so that you get a break and then it goes back to the torture. So it's really good in that way, how it sort of mixes up the film. I really like the pacing and the way the scenes are put together. What I also like about the movie is, as I sort of said before, the film knows it's a gory torture film, so it doesn't try to sort of add other elements in there. I like how this film, the characters, there's not really a lot of escape scenes. You'll have so many films where characters get kidnapped and there's a scene of them trying to escape and then they get caught, and then the characters trying to escape again and then they get caught, and then they're trying to escape again and they get caught. This film is wonderful because it's really just about the torture of the characters and the gory scenes, and as I said, it's sometimes even sexual, so it really doesn't try to throw any other elements into it there. You know what you're getting going into the film, so if that's what you're expecting, you're going to be very entertained. And it really depends how you judge a film like this, if it succeeds, because I almost think that no one is just entertained with straight up torture and gore. I mean, it's unsettling, but if you judge these films based on how much they make you squirm or how uncomfortable they make you feel, I think this film is a success in that merit, because actually for me, just the way when I watch this movie, it's not so much the gory and torture films that make me feel uncomfortable, but it's actually some of the sexual scenes. I won't give anything away, but they actually make me feel the most uncomfortable, and it's when you feel unsettling and you want to look away or you want to just maybe take a break. If the film does that, then I think a film like this, if it can do that, then it succeeds. So I recommend that as long as people know what they're getting before going into this film, I recommend that the people who enjoy these type of films watch this one, because it's actually more of the really recent torture films that have come out of Japan. So it's really well done. It looks terrific. All the scenes are excellent. And some people may or may not prefer the ending, but there's not very long, but it's a few minutes near the end of the film that it sort of gets odd and quirky, like Japanese films do, and I actually like that touch at the end. Anything that can sort of, you know, try to be not lighthearted necessarily, but sort of change the feel is much appreciated, because most of the film is just, it doesn't let go. It's scene after scene of brutal torture, so I find that anything breaks it up really helps. So if you are looking into these films, then this one's one of the best. Like I said, I do feel it's one of the best just because it's newer, and I think it's learned a lot from earlier films of its subgenre, and it's very well done. So I recommend that, you know, you give this film a look.